As a part of regular maintenance, you should always keep your system up to date and apply necessary patches whenever they're available. If you're updating your production server, I recommend you to test on a virtual environment first, just to make sure that it won't break any of your services. And if everything looks good, you can go ahead and apply those updates on your server. And let's see how we can do that on Ubuntu server first, and then we'll go to the Red Hat server. So on Ubuntu, you could do sudo apt-get update to update the repository first. And after your repository is updated, you can actually go and perform the upgrade. Sudo apt-get upgrade, and you can use -y switch to answer yes. So there's nothing to be upgraded and nothing to be installed because I do it regularly, so there is nothing new. So these commands automatically upgrade your packages and OS, including kernel images if they're available. But as a part of regular system maintenance, you would also have to keep an eye on the disk space as your older packages, libraries, and kernel images gets accumulated over time and they take space in your hard drive. And it's always best to delete those old packages and dependencies that you do not need, broken library files, and any unused kernel images. But before you start the cleanup process after your system is updated, you should always restart your system so that the system is running with the latest version of packages and the kernel images. And once your system is up, you can use sudo apt-get clean command. This command clears out the local repository of any retrieved package files, and it removes cache from this directory. And it removes everything except these two files, log file and partial directory. And the next command you can run is sudo apt-get auto clean. Like clean command we just ran, auto clean also clears out the local repository of any retrieved package files. The difference between them is it only removes the package files that can no longer be downloaded and largely useless. So if you run the clean command, you might not have to run this command again. So these two commands that we just ran remove downloaded packages from archives, but do not touch the installed packages and dependencies. So to remove packages that are installed automatically as a part of dependencies for other programs, you have to use auto remove command, but auto removes also removes your older kernel images. So let's verify what kernel we're running. So we are running 5.13.035. But if you want to list down all the kernel images installed in your system, including new and old, you can use dpkz --list command, and let's filter kernel binaries and kernel source header. So Linux images is kernel binary, and we can do Linux header for the header source. So these are the header source and Linux kernel image binary files that are currently installed in the system. But our system is running with 5.13.0-35, which is this one. So this is actually Linux kernel binary file, and these are the header files. You'll only need the header files if you want to customize kernel or want to build something that uses the kernel function. It's not needed in most of the cases. So on Ubuntu 16.04 and newer, you can actually use sudo apt-get auto remove command to remove packages, but it keeps the configuration files. And to clear the configuration file as well, you need to do -purge. But in some versions of Ubuntu, this command only removes older kernel if it was part of automatic security update. But if it was manual install by using apt-get install command, then this command will not remove those old kernel images. And in that case, what you can do is you can actually manually purge all the old kernel images that you do not need by typing sudo apt-get purge and then Linux image, which you want to, so out of these three, whichever is the older one and you do not need, you can just remove this way. And then you have to use sudo update grub to update your grub file. But instead of doing that, you can also mark the package for auto removal using auto remove command, which takes care of everything automatically. I think in Ubuntu, auto remove keeps at least one spare kernel version other than your current version, if in case current version does not work and you need to boot from the older kernel. And Ubuntu maintains the list of kernel in this file. 01 auto remove kernel. So these are the kernels that will be kept when you run auto remove command. So if you do apt mark and show auto, and then type Linux image and everything like we did before. So these are the kernel images that were downloaded and installed automatically using software updater. And if you do, instead of show auto, if you do show manual, there is no kernel images that was manually downloaded and installed. So this is the command that we just ran. We just replaced show auto. And there is no kernel images that are downloaded manually and installed using apt-get command. But if there were, what you could do is you could do sudo apt-mark and then auto and whatever the Linux kernel that was downloaded and installed manually. And after you give the kernel image, press enter, and that Linux kernel image will be marked for auto removal. And you can actually run sudo apt-get auto remove hyphen hyphen purge. So there's not much to remove from my system, and you just press Y. It will then delete any unwanted packages, broken library files, any unwanted dependencies, and any old kernel images that you do not need, but it keeps at least one other version of kernel image than what you're currently running on. You can also see what kernel image it's loading from. So currently our system is booting from 5.13.0-35 inside boot folder, this one. And if you're using Red Hat system, you can actually type sudo yum info. So these are the available packages in your system. And you can also run sudo yum check update to check for any update. And if you're only interested in security related update, you can use hyphen hyphen security switch. So nothing is there. You can use sudo yum update and give the package name if you just want to update the particular package. But if you want to update the whole system, you can give hyphen y. So everything is updated. There's nothing to do. And instead of doing manual updates, if you want your system to be updated automatically, you can actually download this DNF automatic package. Let's look at the package information. So this is the package that you can install and configure the package to update your system automatically. And now to clean up your Red Hat system, you can first actually list the kernel images. Or you could do rpm hyphen qa kernel. So these are the two kernel images that are installed in my system, but it is running with 348.20. And if you do sudo m clean all, so it will remove the cache of repositories which are enabled inside m.repository and all these files. And in Red Hat, you can also list down the packages that will be removed by auto remove command by using yum list hyphen hyphen auto remove command. So if you run the auto remove command, these packages will be deleted. And if you think these packages are no longer needed, you can actually use auto remove command. And if you're only concerned about removing older kernel images, you can also use some specific command to remove kernel images only. If you're using Red Hat 5, 6, or 7, you can use package cleanup command, package cleanup hyphen hyphen old kernels. And then you can give the count how many kernel images that you want to keep in the system. So this command is for Red Hat 5, 6, and 7, but I'm using Red Hat 8. And in Red Hat 8, you should use sudo yum remove old install only. And this command keeps the latest kernel version and the kernel version that's currently running. So it will delete these kernel images. Is that okay? And if I say yes, it will delete that. And if we want to keep more versions, we can use sudo m remove yum repo query hyphen hyphen install only, but keep at least two. So it means skip the latest two packages. And if you do one, then it will keep only one latest package and delete the rest. This command is similar to sudo m remove old install only. So this way you can maintain your Ubuntu server or Red Hat Enterprise Linux server by removing unwanted packages, old dependencies file that you do not need anymore, and old kernel images so that your file system will be free. So this will be it for this video. And next week I'll come up with another Linux video. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being with me on this video. And I'll see you next week. Take care.